हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। टुडे वी आर बिगिनिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज गैस पावर साइकिल्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अवर न्यू टॉपिक वी विल रिविजिट अवर टॉपिक्स ऑफ प्रीवियस चैप्टर दैट इज वेपर पावर साइकिल। So regarding regenerative cycle, this was the second modification in our standard Rankine cycle after reheat cycle. So here what we were doing in regenerative cycle, here we are taking some part of steam in between the expansion process into the heater. So this kind of modification is done twice, that is two times the steam is taken in the turbine and it is taken into heaters. Now this steam is actually utilized to heat the feed water or the water which is coming out of the condenser. And this is the TS diagram for the same arrangement, and in this way we are calculating the efficiency for regeneration cycle. Steam rate is given by this formula and the regeneration is compared in this way, that is with regeneration the mean temperature of heat addition is obtained with this formula, that is the ratio of enthalpy to entropy between point number 1 and point number 10, and without regeneration the same ratio is between point number 1 and point number 6. So we can clearly see that the mean temperature of heat addition has been increased with the help of regeneration. So the efficiency of regenerative cycle is more than the standard Rankine cycle. And these are the energy balance which are useful in calculating the mass which is bleed off. Then we have done the same analysis for 1 kg of steam in this way, where here we are seeing that the hashed portion is the loss in the work output, and this is the HS diagram for the same arrangement. The next theory was reheat regenerative cycle, that is we are combining reheat with regeneration. In this, modern steam power plant is equipped with both. So here you can see that we are having a combination of regeneration, that is the steam is taken in between and used in these heaters. At the same time we are having the steam is taken back into boiler and it is reheated and then returned into LP turbine. So this is the combination of reheat and regeneration. Here we are having the TS diagram of this arrangement. WT is the work output that we are getting, and WP is the work input that we require in the pumps, and in this way we can calculate the efficiency based on WT and WP with Q1 and Q2. These are the energy balances for heaters 1, 2 and 3. The next theory was feed water heaters, and this is the arrangement of feed water heaters. There are two types of heaters, open heaters and closed heaters. In our previous theory, that was in regeneration, open heaters were used, where mixing of steam was allowed. And in closed heaters, this kind of arrangement is there. That is, the feed water is passing through the pipes and the steam is in the shell. This is the TS diagram for the same. And here the difference between the temperature of point E and O as well as the temperature difference between G and L is known as terminal temperature pressure difference of heater. Now there are few advantages of open heaters. There are simplicity, lower cost, high heat transfer capacity, and closed heaters are costly and may not give up as high a field water temperature as do the open heaters. And these were few numericals that I gave you in self-study. So that was end of vapor power cycle. So now we have completed this chapter and we will begin a new chapter, that is gas power cycles. So let's begin. So we will revisit our standard cycle, that is Carnot cycle. These are PV and TS diagram for Carnot cycle. If we recall, this is 1 to 2, if you recall. Is isothermal heat addition, then two to three is isentropic compression. So first, if we discuss isothermal heat addition, that you can see over here, 1 to 2 is this. Is isothermal heat addition, that can be seen over here. Then 2 to, and the same can be seen here, that with heat addition entropy is increasing and temperature is remaining constant because of isothermal nature. Here in heat addition process, the pressure is reducing and the volume is increasing. Then we are having isentropic expansion. That can be seen over here, that 2 to 3 the pressure is reducing and temperature is increasing, volume is increasing. Then the same can be seen over here, that because of isentropic nature the entropy is remaining constant, that is over here, and temperature is reducing because of expansion process. Then the process 3 to 4 is isothermal heat rejection. and then from 4 to 1 we are having. So to further discuss 3 to 4, here you can see the isothermal heat rejection portion like this, and 3 to 4 here, as it is heat rejection, the entropy is getting decreased from 3 to 4, and temperature is remaining constant. Now 4 to 1 is again isentropic compression. That can be seen over here from 4 to 1. And here the entropy is remaining constant, but in compression the temperature is increasing. Now let's quickly go through the equations. Q122, that is over here, that is given by RT1 ln V2 by V1. So here V2 is more than V1, so this is the positive value, so this is the heat which is being added. And the same can be written for work output. Now what is how the second equation is written, let's see this portion. Q is equal to delta U plus W. That, as you know, that this is our first law of thermodynamics, where C is function of temperature only. So here, as the temperature is remaining constant from 1 to 2, the internal energy changes will be zero. That's why we can say that Q is equal to 0 plus W. That's why we are getting Q is equal to W. So directly the same value is put for W122, and consider this as positive value because we are having the heat addition and V2 by V1 is greater than 1, that's why it will remain positive. Now second is Q223, in which this is isentropic process, that's why there will be no heat transfer and it will have this value 0 because of isentropic nature, that is reversible adiabatic, no heat transfer is happening here in compression process, expansion process, sorry, it should be expansion. Now the value of W, that is work output, is given by this formula, and we are doing the whole analysis for 1 kg. That's why you are not seeing any kind of mass present in equations. So based on our standard formulas, W is equal to mc delta T, that is final temperature minus initial temperature, that is our standard formula. So we can say this to be C into delta T. So it is Cv into T3 minus T2, but as you can see the value of T3 is lower than T2, so this term will be actually negative. To keep the work output value as positive, we are adding negative sign over here. So here actually we are getting work output, so the negative sign is put here. Finally we can write down for this as Cv into T2 minus T3 which will result in positive work output. Next is Q34, that is over here, RT2 ln V4 by V3, that is following the same equation like this, and it is also following this way because of isothermal d delta U will be 0, so Q is equal to W. So whatever we are getting value of Q34 will be equal to W34, and similarly for the fourth and last process Q421 will be for isentropic compression, heat will be 0 and Q421 is written in this way. And if you see carefully here, the temperature difference, which is T1 minus T4, is actually positive value. This term T1 minus T4 is actually a positive value, but here work input is required in this process. That's why to keep this value to be negative, we have put negative sign over here. So finally what we are getting here is equal to Cv into T4 minus T1. So this will be a negative value because we need to provide work input over here. And for process 2 to 3, for process 2 to 3 and for process 4 to 1, both are isentropic process, so we can utilize this equation. V2 by V3 is equal to T2 by T1 raised to 1 upon gamma minus 1, and V1 by V4 is equal to T2 by T1 raised to 1 upon gamma minus 1. So as these ratios are equal, let me slightly go into detail that how these equations are written. It should be like this: V2 by V3 is equal to T2 by T3 raised to 1 divided by 1 minus gamma. That was our real formula. So if you see carefully, here we can write down the formula as so here we are slightly making some modifications. So let's forget this for a while. Over here, let's forget this. We will erase this later on. Let's have this ratio, that is V2 by V3. That is, here this ratio with this ratio of volume is equal to T mean over T max. Now what is this T mean and T max? This will be our T mean and this is our T max. So what is happening over here is, because here we are writing this as a T1 and here as T2, it is creating confusion with the points 1, 2, 3, 4. So instead of writing T1 and T2, we will write down Tmax and Tmin from now on. So this is the value, as well as if we write down V4 by V1, sorry, V1 by V4, then it will be equal to again T mean, here the ratio is 1, the power is 1 minus 1 upon 1, 1 divided by gamma minus 1, and here it is T max into raised to 1 divided by gamma minus 1. So what we are getting here is, if we combine these two equations, then we will get that V2 by V3 equal to V1 by V4. So ultimately we can obtain this relationship, that is V2 by V1 is equal to V3 by V4, and Q1 is, again we have repeated this formula which is written from here, that is this. And W net can be written as Q1 minus Q2, that is R ln V2 by V1 T1 minus T2. So when you take the difference between these two, if we write down the difference, then W net is equal to R T1 ln V2 by V1 minus R T2 ln V4 by V3. So here, instead of V4 by V3, we can write down V2 by V1. So continuing from here, R T1 ln V2 by V1 as it is minus R T2 ln V2 by V1.
Here are some things you can do when your phone's offline.
So finally what we are getting here, R ln V2 by V1 into T1 minus T2. That is the same equation is written here, and finally we are getting this as the cycle efficiency. So the only correction in this slide is you need to consider T1 and T2 as Tmax and Tmin respectively. Now our next theory is Otto cycle. So this is the PV and TS diagram for the same. The figure shows the air standard cycle. Now what is the meaning of air standard cycle? Here the meaning of air standard cycle is, we will be using working fluid as an air, and it will be considered as an ideal gas. So that is the meaning of air standard cycle. Now it consists of two reversible adiabatics and two reversible isopores. We will see them one by one. First is air is compressed in 1 to 2 reversibly and adiabatically. That is this process. As you can see, it is compressed, so volume is reducing and pressure is increasing. It is happening isentropically, that is reversible adiabatic, so entropy is remaining constant, and the same can be found over here also from process 1 to 2. That entropy is remaining constant. As it is compression process, we are observing an increase in temperature, increase in pressure and decrease in volume. Heat is then added to air reversibly at constant volume in process 2 to 3. So this is the heat addition process which is there from 2 to 3. As it is a constant pressure process, the volume is remaining constant, pressure is increasing, and due to heat addition, temperature is increasing as well as entropy is also increasing. Okay, and let me tell you one more thing, that when I write down constant pressure, constant volume, volume, the meaning is isochoric process. Okay, that's why you are observing reversible isochore. Then work done by air in expanding reversibly and adiabatically in process 2 to 3. Sorry, it should be here 3 to 4. So here in 3 to 4 expansion is happening, which is reversible and adiabatic. So here in expansion, pressure is reducing, volume is increasing. Because of expansion, temperature is reducing and entropy is remaining constant because of adiabatic reversible process. Then heat is rejected into constant volume process from 4 to 1. That is, here heat is rejected at constant volume, and here entropy is reducing and temperature is also reducing. So now we will do the calculation of efficiency for this. Let m be the fixed mass of air undergoing the cycle operations. As mentioned above. So now we will do calculations for this on our virtual board. So now let's begin the analysis part. First is heat supply. Now the heat addition process is happening where? It is happening from process 2 to 3, that we can see here. So let us say this as Q1, that is heat addition, which is happening from Q2 to 3. And it as this is the constant pressure process, we can write down एम सी वी टी थ्री माइनस टी टू. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज हीट रिजेक्टेड. That is equal to Q2, which is there from process 4 to 1, which is equal to M CV heat rejection is happening from T4 to T1. Now efficiency eta is equal to W net upon Q1, that is equal to Q2 upon minus, sorry, here it should be Q1 minus Q2 by Q1, which is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1 is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2. So this will be the efficiency of this cycle, and now we will go into detail of the temperature relations. That is, first we will see process 1 to 2. Which T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1, and process 3 to 4 is T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 raised to gamma minus 1. So here V4 is nothing but, if you see this, V4 is equal to, we can write down V4 as V1 because both volume are same. So here it will be V1, and here instead of V3 we can write down V2. So this will be also gamma minus 1. So when we combine these two, we will be getting T2 by T3 is equal to, sorry, T2 by T1. T2 by T1 is equal to T3 by T4. So what we have done, we have simply equated these two. So now T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. So now what we can do is T4 by T1 minus 1 is equal to T3 by T2 minus 1. So based on this, what we will be getting here is T4 minus T1 by T1 is equal to T3 minus T2 by T2. So what we'll be getting here is T4 by T4 minus T1 divided by T3 by minus T2 is equal to T1 upon T2, which is equal to V2 by V1 raised to gamma minus 1. So taking this equation into our main efficiency equation, so here it will be 1 minus V2 by V1 raised to gamma minus 1, which is equal to 1 minus 1 upon RK raised to gamma minus 1. What is RK here? RK is equal to V1 divided by V2, that is volume before compression divided by volume after compression. So this is the derivation of the Otto cycle efficiency. We can copy this now. And here the efficiency of air standard Otto cycle is a function of compression ratio only, as it is proved over here. As we have proved this portion, that the efficiency eta is equal to 1 minus 1 upon RK raised to gamma minus 1. That is, eta is now function of compression ratio only. The higher the compression ratio, the higher will be the efficiency, as it can be seen over here also. It is independent of temperature levels at which the cycle operates. However, the compression ratio cannot be increased beyond a certain limit because of noisy and destructive combustion phenomena known as detonation. It also depends on the fuel, engine design and the operating condition. And figure shows the effect of compression ratio along with the specific heat ratio. So for higher gamma, we will have higher efficiency, but for air, we are having the gamma value as 1.4. Now we will have another calculations for this cycle, which are the work output values. So we need to calculate W net now. W net in this case is given by this formula, that is P3 V3 minus P4 V4 by gamma minus 1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. So here, let's say V1 by V2 is equal to RK, that we have already seen the compression ratio, that is the volume before compression divided by volume after compression. So what we can write down, V1 is equal to RK into V2, and V1 is equal to V4, as we can see in this. So here is equal to RK into V4. These all things will be important, so you should be doing this with me. So now P2 by P1 is equal to P3 by P4, which is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma. So what we are getting here, RK raised to gamma. Now one more thing is P3 by P2. Let's assume P3 by P2 is equal to P4 by P1 is equal to RP, that is pressure ratio. Now we will write down this equation W net. So W net is equal to let's take P1 V1 by gamma minus 1 common. So what we will be having inside, P3 V3 by P1 V1 minus P4 V4 by P1 V1 minus P2 V2 by P1 V1 minus plus 1. So what we have done, that we have taken common P1 V1 by gamma minus 1 from the entire equation. Is equal to P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1. Now I will do a separate calculation here for this. That is, we are having P3 V3 by P1 V1. So P3 by P2 multiplied by P2 by P1 multiplied by V3 instead of V3, if we can change it, instead of V3 we can write down V2. So here V2 by V1. So here instead of P3 by P2 we can write down RP multiplied by, instead of P2 by P1 we can write down RK raised to gamma, and instead of V1 by V2 we can put RK instead of V1 by V2. So here what we will be getting, here we can write down RP into RK raised to gamma minus 1. Now instead of P4 by P1 here V1 is equal to V4, so this will get automatically cancelled. These two will be same. And now instead of P4 by P1 we can directly write down RP, which can be seen here. Now next is P2 by P1 is RK raised to gamma, that is visible over here, P2 by P1. Now instead of V2 by V1 we can put V1 by V2, we can put RK in the denominator plus 1. So now finally what we are getting here is P1 V1 divided by gamma minus 1 into RP into RK raised to gamma minus 1 minus RP minus RK raised to gamma minus 1 plus 1. That is the value of W net. So this is the network output that we have calculated. Now our next portion is mean effective pressure. Mean effective pressure is given by W net that we have calculated divided by V1 minus V2. Now here let's do separate calculations for V1 minus V2. V1 minus V2. So let's take V2 common is equal to V2 into V1 by V2 minus 1. So here we will be getting V2 into RK minus 1. So finally we can write down the whole equation as P1 V1 upon gamma minus 1 into V2 into RK minus 1 into this whole portion, that is RK raised to gamma minus 1 minus RP minus RK raised to gamma minus 1 plus 1. So what we'll be getting here, instead of V1 by V2 we can put RK. So P1 into RK divided by gamma minus 1 RK minus 1 into RP RK raised to gamma minus 1 minus RP minus RK raised to gamma minus 1 plus 1. So this is the value of mean effective pressure. So let's copy this portion. Let's edit over here. Now our next theory is diesel cycle. Here the PV and TS diagram are provided. Let's begin with process 1 to 2. Here the air is compressed reversibly and adiabatic from 1 to 2, that is the process over here. Pressure is increasing, volume is decreasing, that is the compression process. As it is isentropic one, the entropy is remaining constant, temperature is increasing because of compression. Then the heat is then added to it from external source reversibly at constant pressure in 2 to 3. So here the only difference from the previous cycle is this, that the heat is added at constant pressure. So pressure is remaining constant and volume is increasing. Because of heat addition, we are having the increase in temperature as well as increase in entropy. Then air expands reversibly and adiabatic in process 3 to 4. This is usual process that we have seen in our previous theory also, that pressure is reducing, volume is increasing, entropy is remaining constant and temperature is reducing because of the expansion process. Then the heat is rejected reversibly at constant volume from process 4 to 1. So here heat rejection is happening at constant volume. Volume is remaining constant, pressure is decreasing, and here entropy is decreasing and temperature is also decreasing in this way. Now let's do the cycle analysis for this. Now here the heat added, that is Q1, is added here in Q2 to 3, that is equal to mCp T3 minus T2. Then heat rejected is Q2, which is equal to Q4 to 1, that is equal to mCv into T4 minus T1. If you see carefully, here we are using specific heat at constant pressure because process 2 to 3 is at constant pressure. Now eta is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, which is equal to 1 minus, here we will have Cv T4 minus T1 divided by Cp T3 minus T2, that is equal to 1 minus T4 by T1 divided by gamma into T3 minus T2. Now we will define three different ratios. First is compression ratio. Which is equal to RK, which is V1 by V2. So this is the compression which is happening. So V1 is the volume before compression and V2 is the volume after compression. The next is expansion ratio. Which is R E value, which is the value V4 by V3. Here expansion is happening over here from 3 to 4, so V3 is the, V4 is the final volume after compression divided by initial volume before compression. The next is cutoff ratio. RC is equal to V3 by V2, and this is the volume change during heat addition process, V3 by V2. Now let's focus on RK. RK is equal to V1 by V2. So let's do this here, multiply and divide it with V3. So here instead of V1 we can write down V4. Instead of V1 we can write down V4. So here is equal to V4 by V3 multiplied by V3 by V2. So it can be seen that here this is RE into RC. That is the value of RQ. So these are the three ratios. Now let's focus on process 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3. Here T4 by T3 is equal to B3 by B4 raised to gamma minus 1, which is equal to 1 divided by 3 to 4 is expansion process, so here we can write down this as RE raised to gamma minus 1. So T4 is equal to T3 divided by RE raised to gamma minus 1. And here we have proved that instead of RE, we can write down RK upon RC. So we can say T3 into RC raised to gamma minus 1 upon RK raised to gamma minus 1. That is the value of T4. Now the next process is process 2 to 3. Which is constant pressure process. So here T2 by T3 is equal to V2 by V3, which is equal to 1 upon RC, which is quite evident from here. So the value of T2 is equal to T3 divided by RC. This is the value we have obtained. Now process 1 to 2. Here T1 by T2 is equal to V2 by V1 raised to gamma minus 1, which is equal to 1 upon RK raised to gamma minus 1. So here we can write down T1 is equal to T2 into 1 upon RK raised to gamma minus 1, which is equal to T3 upon RC into 1 divided by RK raised to gamma minus 1. That is the value of T1. So if you see carefully, we have taken all temperatures in form of T3 and we are going to utilize them in this equation, that is here. So now let's quickly write down this. Eta equal to 1 minus 1 upon gamma. If you see that blue box, T4 minus T1, so instead of T4 we can write down RC raised to gamma minus 1 divided by RK raised to gamma minus 1. That is for T4 we have written, here T3 will be present. minus, after t4 we have t1, so t1 is here, that is t3 into 1 upon rc into 1 divided by r a raised to gamma minus 1 divided by t2. For that t2 we are having t3 into 1 upon rc, sorry, t3 is there only, so t3 minus t3 into 1 upon rc. So finally we can write down this as 1 minus 1 upon gamma into 1 upon r k raised to gamma minus 1 common. Here we will have r c raised to gamma minus 1 minus 1 upon r c divided by r c minus 1 into numerator we will have r c. So we have eliminated t3 and we have done some mathematical simplification. So finally what we will be getting here is equal to 1 minus 1 upon gamma into 1 upon r k raised to gamma minus 1 into r c raised to gamma minus 1 upon r c minus 1. That is the value of efficiency for the diesel cycle. Okay, now we will move forward to our next topic. Here we have already seen the mean effective pressure as ratio of network output to swept volume. The brake thermal efficiency, it is defined as the ratio of power developed by the engine in kilowatt, that is here in numerator, to the heat supplied by the fuel, that is fuel supplied in kg per second into CV, that is calorific value of the fuel in kilojoule per kg. Next is relative efficiency. It is the ratio of indicated thermal efficiency to corresponding air standard efficiency, which is given by this formula. And here we are ending this lecture now, and we will continue this chapter in our next lecture. Thank you for watching this video.